Hey guys, this is the video by Posupata, which is apparently from the anime 86. I haven't watched the anime, so I'm not really sure what this is supposed to be. It seems to be some kind of a mech robot thingy. We've got a rotor and a landing gear on these arms here. Some directional thrusters. So I'm guessing this thing is supposed to like hover over the ground here. The arms themselves seem to be sitting on rigid structures. So these are not subgrids on hinges or rotors. And to the side here, we've got the new atmospheric thrusters. Alright, down here, what's that thing over there? So this thing actually has a survival kit down here. That's always nice to see on any build actually. To the back here, we've got more engines. What's that? Oh, that's the back part of the survival kit there. A warfare battery and a backup camera. Wait a second, is this the front of the vehicle? No, I don't think this is the front of the vehicle. Look at that bus up there, by the way, that's from the previous video. And a medium cargo container access port to the side here. To the top of the vehicle. There's some components up here. This AO2H2 generator with the hydrogen engine and the conveyor sorter. I like how all these things are put together to make this, you know, kind of mechanical look of the vehicle. I think that's pretty smart. So the only subgrids on this vehicle are the arms of the vehicle. Oh, and the vehicle is 2,287 PCO with 289 blocks. Alright, how do we drive this thing? I found the entrance. Oh, so this bit over here is actually the front of the vehicle. Obviously, you don't have any visibility from the first person view here. So you gotta use the camera. I guess I just move the thing then. Oh, there we go. So, you know, this is pretty much a rigid wheels hovercraft, which is very reliable, especially if you want an efficient method of ground transport on space engineers. Alright, let's pick up some speed here. Oof. Yeah, this is actually a... Well, alright, I think the vehicle needs more gyroscopes. So, you know, it can recover faster. Is this the arm control button? This one here. Arm controller control, which doesn't seem to be doing anything. Oh, it has like a small landing gear down there. There we go. So there's like some kind of a hinge lock that you need to unlock first before you can control the arm using the arm controller. I guess that other one is for the... Oh, what the hell? So there's a hinge lock and there's a rotor lock as well. Huh, this is actually quite smart. It's like a garbage collector. Hold on, let me try something here. Hey, are you done with that cargo of explosive? Hoshiro-san? Kind of tricky to control actually. Hold on. Alright, let's grab the cargo of explosive. Height is too far. Retract the landing gear. There you go. Oh, it's too heavy. Hold on. Maybe that was too much explosive. There you go. Are you guessing this? This is pretty cool. So, you know, you can grab stuff and possibly put stuff. Let me try to put it back on the truck here. So if I extend my landing gear, then I can, you know, lift and put stuff like this without moving the vehicle. This is very sturdy when you have the landing gear on the floor like that. That's a pretty smart design. Oh wow, this vehicle is actually more interesting than I thought before. I think I can actually lift the truck here. Let me try that. Here goes. That's amazing. Alright, let me put it there. Well, unlock the landing gears. Oh wait. Well. Come on, lift the thing. Yeah, we're not gonna be able to pick up a whole truck like this. Still though, it's pretty cool that you can, you know, actually lift stuff like this. I really like this vehicle. Alright, let's try to drive while we're lifting that thing over there. Yeah, I mean, this is actually pretty doable, especially if you're not carrying stuff that are too heavy. This is actually fun. I feel like I'm stealing something from someone. Alright, let's see how well this handles a cliff. Here goes. I'll still be carrying the box there. I think we should be fine. Hold on. Alright. We're fine. Well, I mean, you know. Well, that should be easy to repair. Hold on, I got a very genius idea here. So if we anchor ourselves to the ground over here, then, you know, we grab the rock over there with the the arms cannot reach that far. I was thinking maybe we can, like, you know, climb a cliff or a mountain by anchoring ourselves to the ground like this, and then just, you know, pulling ourselves with the other arm, and then keeps repeating the process. But well, I guess that's not really possible. Well, let's arm the vehicle. Alright, I'm actually pretty decent with hovercraft, so I'm pretty confident that this is actually gonna go very well for us. Here goes. Come on, I just need to change direction every so often to dodge the enemy fire. We've already destroyed one turret. This is actually working well. We're not exploding. Wait, did we actually? Hold on, there's still one more turret. Come on, disable the turret. We're still getting shot at. Come on. I need to set my turret to target. Wait, did we disable the turret? No, there's still one more. Come on, we're smoking. We're still fine though, we're still moving. Wait, what the hell? I lost propulsion? What happened? I cannot move anymore. I think I ran out of batteries. Oh yeah, the only battery in the vehicle got destroyed. But you know, that was still quite an impressive performance considering this wasn't designed to do combat or battles. Not to mention the ability to carry stuff as well. Oh, by the way, this build also got AI blocks in it, so you know, you can actually use the AI to do combat stuff if you want, or you just want the vehicle to follow you or whatever. The vehicle got a survival kit, and not to mention that it's also low PCU as well. So all things considered, this is a pretty decent practical vehicle. You can probably add like an ore detector on the vehicle to make it even more functional. Let me check actually. Alright, so the vehicle doesn't have an ore detector already. My only suggestions to this vehicle would be to add more gyroscope so you can have more control when you're starting to flip over, so that you can recover easier. And well, if you want to use this for combat or battles, you can probably add some batteries to make it more survivable. This is actually a pretty decent and fun vehicle to use. So, that's the video by Posupata. You guys can find the link in the description below. Come on. I've returned.